Hey guys, how you doing? It's Kevin, jack of all trades, king of nothing. And today, we're gonna hang this vintage council tool axe head on this sexy French curve handle. Let's do it. All right, the axe head in question here is a vintage council tool 4-pound felling axe head. And you can see here that I've already done some work. This was found in the basement of my grandparents' farmhouse. Is who knows how old. I couldn't say. Some of you might be able to tell me. But I've already cleaned up the head a good bit. It was rusty, and I left as much patina as I could. I went ahead and ground the pole straight. You guys can see that. I just did that on my shop sander. And then I went ahead and ground the cheeks flat. I just did that with a file, and you can see it's not sharp yet. I'll put a secondary bevel on that once I'm done hanging it. All right, here you can see the beautiful handle that this is. This was produced by Killinger. He's on YouTube. Check him out. He makes some gorgeous handles. They're hard to come by. This is what he calls the French curve. And he started to leave this large block on the end. That way you can hit it on the bottom squarely, hang it the way you want it, and then cut off the palm swell in any fashion that you like. And I like that because I don't like those big palm swells. The first problem that I'm going to have with it, it's not really a problem, but a challenge, is that you get a massive eye in case you have like a 4.5-5 pound L-well or something and you need a big eye to hang it on. I don't, and you can see here I've already done some work where I'm gonna have to take a lot of wood off of that eye in order to make this fit, but that's not a problem. This needs no slimming. I should say that right off the bat. It is a slim taper, as slim as you're gonna find on the market. And it is a little fatter down here so it doesn't roll in your hand, and a little flatter up here, just the way I like it. And right now, as it stands, I cut that off. Yeah, I mean, we're going to be down in the 26, 27 inch range, which is going to be really interesting. That's why I was excited to try out this handle. I don't really like heavy axe heads, but I think a lot of that is because they tend to be hung on long handles, like 32 inches or better. Okay, now you can see what we got after I cut the back off with the bandsaw. I still have a lot of wood to remove there before we get even close to being able to fit this inside of that eye. So I think I'm gonna be a little brave and use the flap disc grinder to remove some of this wood, and then we'll switch to a rasp. Yeah. Let's do it. Okay, now that I have the rough shape worked out, and considering that I'm gonna bring the head all the way down into this area, I can probably get rid of some of this area, and then I'll start removing some more of the wood here with the rasp. So let's cut some of that off and work on this. There you go, I cut off some and retraced the eye, and you can see what we're at. We're much closer now. I'm sure as I move down, it's gonna be a little fatter here, but close enough that I'm gonna switch over to the Shinto rasp and start taking off some more material and see if we can get it to fit in the eye and then start shaping from there. All right, guys, I think we're ready for our first real fit here. We can see now that it slips on there, not quite halfway, but almost. This isn't really intended to be a how-to video. I made a video a couple months ago, one of my first videos on how to hang an axe, so check that out if you want more specifics. All right, it's down. Not quite there yet. For those of you who do this often, you know we got a ways to go to get down here, but for a first fit, that's not tea bag. Okay. I think you guys can see there that we're hitting wood almost all the way around. Not in this area and not in this area, but it's plenty fat down here. So once we get down there, we'll be just fine. Not too bad for a first fit, but we got at least that far to go again. So I'll get with you guys when we're almost down. Guys, I think we're just about there. I'm gonna jump this on one time and see where we're at, but we're lined up nice, and I think one more time is gonna be it. I'll jump this on one more time. I'll show you guys, take it off, show you guys where we're at, clean it up, take the opportunity to sand up around here, and then we're gonna put a kerf in this, slam a wedge in it, and call it good. I did chip a bit off of the palm swell here. I know that I'm gonna go ahead and cut a good portion of this off, so it's no big deal. But if you wanted to leave a big palm swell here, you probably should chamfer the edges. You guys know what I'm talking about. I don't need to tell you guys how to hang an axe, you know. All right, so there's where we're at. You can see that there. That's, you know, you could go down a little bit further, and I probably will when I clean it up, but that's pretty good. So let's take it off. I'll show you where we're at and put a kerf in it and slam it down. Okay, there's where we're at. You can see we got contact all the way around there and almost all the way around here. It starts right there. We got a little bit of a gap in contact right here, so I think I'm going to take a little bit more of this down, which will allow the head to jump down a little more and hopefully get some contact all the way around. That's what we want. At this point, I'm no longer using the Shinto rasp nor the aggressive bastard file there. I am down to a foreign hand, and on the foreign hand, you guys know, but you're not really looking to just take this line out, but take some material down here out too if you want to move the head down further. So that's what we're going to do. We're not trying to take much out at this point, though I am going to start with the aggressive side right there. And again, if you don't want to do this freehand, put it in a vise or something. I just like to be able to move it around. I'm only doing this now because it's harder to sand around this area later. The handle itself doesn't really need sanded down. It came perfectly ready to use. Didn't need slimmed, didn't need sanded, only need fitted. But where I put these deep Shinto rasp marks up by the head here, I want to get those out. All right, guys, final fit. We got the kerf in her. See how it goes. One more whack with the brass hammer. Let's say it's down. Yep. Oh yeah. That's where we want to be. No gaps whatsoever in that. And most importantly, we still have some room for a wedge up there. So let's put the wedge in. We're lined up nice and straight. And then put some stain. I think we're gonna put some walnut stain on this guy. That'll be a first for me. If you're just using a wooden wedge and you're not gonna put in any kind of step wedge, then yes, I would suggest you use glue. If you're gonna put in some kind of step wedge, I'm gonna put in a barrel wedge. I think that they are a good idea. I know some people don't. If you don't think they're a good idea, then yeah, you wanna glue it because this could pop back out. But if you put a barrel wedge on top of this, there is no way in hell that this is ever coming out. Let's see if we can get it down first. Tappy tap tap. Already feeling some resistance. Hear it? That's it. She's down, boys. I really like these, and I don't think this would come loose if I didn't put one of these in here, at least not anytime soon, but it's just a fail safe. If you can get one of these in here, you know it's not coming loose if you fitted this well. I think this guy is probably a little bit too big, given that I had trouble getting the wedge in there. So we're gonna step down to this, and I'm gonna put it back here. I can always put another one up there later if I have issues. But I don't think I will, at least not anytime soon. And yes, the handle is secured down here with the clamp that you can't see, so I'm not gonna bang the handle out. What a beautiful sight that is. Look at that mushrooming on top. Look at it. Yeah, that ain't going anywhere anytime soon. She is tight all the way around. One more thing before we put the stain on it. I need to cut off the palm swell here. And essentially what I like to do is hold it where it feels comfortable, which is right about there, and then mark it out. I like to hold right on to the end of it, so that's a preference. You guys do what feels right for you. If you want it, you could keep all this down here, you could curve it, make it straight, you could leave this whole block if you wanted, but I'm gonna cut this off just like this. All right, I'm aware for most of you, I just ruined this handle by cutting this palm swell off so short, but I don't like them. So I'm going to be using it. I know how I like them. All I'm going to do now is just chamfer the edges. All right, I decided before I put the stain on it, I should probably sharpen it, put the secondary bevel on it. So that's what we're going to do. For that, I'm just going to use a file. I'll move you guys in here a little closer and get you a better look.
All right, for those of you who are interested, this is a 6-inch Helco Work Bastard file. It's single cut on one side and double cut on the other. And when new, I really like these files because they cut super aggressively, but they tend to wear out pretty quickly and they're just too short for any real work. So I tend to save them just for draw filing. But I have two of them, and I'm going to use them until they wear out. So, you know, c'est la vie.
Oh, that was definitely the right decision. I was worried about that. I've never stained a handle before. I always just use boiled linseed oil, but man, is that gorgeous.
All right. right, guys, can we just admit that this is a salacious axe? I mean, this is a 4-pound head on a 24.5-inch handle, and it is a friggin' laser beam. I mean, look at it, just dissecting this 15-inch diameter cherry as if it was nothing. And I don't like heavy axes, I really don't. But on this French curve handle, it is sexy as hell. I mean, I leer at this thing sideways as I walk by it in the shop, it's so sexy. Look at it. Gorgeous, man. Tremendous. Stupendous. What an axe.
This is a chopping block too, just like that. Both chopping blocks. Well guys, that's all I got time for today, but you can see in a very short time, I got a sizable chunk again for the cordwood challenge. Getting close to being done, but not quite there. But really today, I just wanted to get out the swing this axe that we built last week. It is a 4-pound head on a 24.5-25-inch slim handle produced by Killinger. Killinger, if you're watching, I just want to let you know that you wondered aloud in a previous video whether your handles ever got hung or not. And you can see here that at least one French curve has been hung on a 4-pound council tool vintage head, and it's a beautiful axe, man. I can truly say that you, Killinger, and also Lane at Lomica Axes are making the
best handles
on the market. So if you're looking for a nice slim handle, look to those guys. And if you've watched this far and you're enjoying the videos, guys, please subscribe, share, comment, like, all that. It really helps. Let's see if we can get to at least 100 subscribers. I don't have social media accounts that I can share this on other than this one. So you guys are going to have to do the work if you like the content and want to see more. In any case, thanks guys. And until next time, I'll see you later. Be safe.